Hey, Sean Jantz here, and I'm going to do a quick Benham plan for Monday, March 4th, and I'm going to do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500, and the other indices that you can find on NADEX. And I'm going to start here on /ES, and typically on Sunday nights, I like to start on the daily chart right there, what I like to consider the eagle view of the market, right? So I consider the four-hour chart, the bird's eye view. This is what I consider the eagle view, where we really fly even higher and really see what's going on in a bigger picture, right? This is roughly, what, 6-8 months worth of price action here. And so when we understand what's going on in the bigger picture, it helps us in our smaller time frame day trades. And so when we're looking here at the daily charts, very obvious that we are, when we're just looking at the bias here, you can see the Christmas low, that was from here to here, so 20% Christmas low. We have just massed, like, I think it was like the biggest start to a year since like 91. I forget exactly when, but like a long time, 30, 25 years. I mean, we've just been just an insane bull run to start the year. And all bull runs never, ever, ever just continue, right? You can clearly see, relatively speaking, based off of past price, all of our indicators are what? We're overbought, right? We are starting to get severely overbought. I do anticipate this week to see some of these bulls tension being released, right? So anticipate possible negative ones, maybe even negative 1.5s this week. So you got to be prepared for those. We are at 5-month highs. Price has not been here 2018 in 5 months. We are also seeing a Sunday night gap, which you'll see here on the smaller time frame. We're having some talks with the China deal. I don't really dive too much deep in that, right? I say I'm a technical trader, but I respect the fundamentals. I understand. I always like to understand what's going on. But like basically, this gap is just making this chart go even higher and more. I want to continue to cycle this chart down, right? So you also need to be mindful of buying, you know, above 2,800 on any of your day trades, because you could literally just get smashed from this chart dumping, right? And a lot of these bulls could be possibly taking lots of profits here. So when we move here to the bird's eye view, the four-hour chart, and you can see the four-hour chart's just been trending, but it does cycle, it almost always cycles, right? Overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold, overbought. What's the next logical progression on this chart, right? And that doesn't mean nothing's 100%, but what's the next logical one? And at least you would know, you can clearly see how overbought this four-hour chart is. At a minimum, don't you dare be buying up here, because all the four-hour chart does is cycle. Like if I were to buy this chart, I mean, I need to see pullbacks. You know, I can really see some decent demand into there. And you might be saying, Sean, the chart's massively bullish. Keep buying. I understand that. But you got to make sure that you buy pullbacks, buy pullbacks, buy pullbacks. You got to understand how this market works, right? So clearly we're overbought. I do want to be looking for cycles to the downside tomorrow, and possible some bear targets, some breakouts, maybe gap fill. So now that we built that story from the eagle view to the bird's eye view, we now jump to the 15-day, 15-minute plot chart. And what I'm doing here is I'm just looking for structure. I'm looking for the best places to buy, the best places to sell. I'm looking for support, resistance, supply, and demand zones. And what I always do is I start exactly where price is, and then I start planning and visualizing. What am I going to do or not do at every single zone if this chart does want to continue to go up into those 5-month highs? And then what am I going to do or not do at every single zone if this chart wants to cycle back down to where all this structure is? So first things first, okay, you can clearly see there's that little bit of a gap fill. Now, with gaps, there's roughly over an 80% chance, and it's actually up to 90% depending on which source you read, 80 to 90% chance that gaps get filled, right? So price closed there on Friday and opens right there on Sunday. There's a gap. See how there's a gap in the chart, okay? 90% chance that that price will get filled. Now here's the catch on that 90%. That gap, 90% chance that gaps do get filled, but that study was based off of all time frames. So it could get filled in an hour. It could get filled in a day. It could get filled in a week, in a month, in a year, in 10 years, right? But there is a 90% chance that price will get filled, and actually it's very small, and so I will be looking for opportunities to get this gap filled tomorrow or Tuesday or Wednesday or even Thursday. Just understand that that gap fill is there. We can use that to see, you can understand when you start watching these trade plans, and I teach. I've been doing this every single day for 5 years. 5 years, go on YouTube. I have a trade plan. I understand how this market works, and I can help you. And you can start. This whole point is you can start learning this on your own as well. So that's to the downside. Let's just talk about quickly, if we continue to go higher, what I'm going to do or not do. So first things first, there's that high bubble at 28.1975. Now, just this chart alone, that is a 15-day high, since this is a 15-day chart. But that is a five-month high. So the higher we continue to go tomorrow, we will have zero, absolute zero, zero structure to the left. For over 4 months. So that's something you just need to understand. And I know what you've been thinking, Sean, it's so overbought, sell it, sell it. No, 100%, right? But I have found selling freight trains with no structure to the left has been very difficult, because typically it can just keep going. What I have found is the best is to wait for this chart to build structure, build change control, then we can look for our sell trigger. So if we do continue to go higher tomorrow, like I said, there's no structure. The only thing that we have to look for sell triggers off of is that plus one deviation. So if we go up into there and find change control, and I would make everything, you can see tomorrow a 0.25 deviation move tomorrow is anywhere from about 5 to 6 points. And you should be taking profits. Now let's talk about if we go lower, because that is where all the structure is, and that's where the bias is. First things first, knowing that this wants to fill the gap and even fill set divergence convergence, but we can't sell right now, okay? We want to wait for a breakout, wait for strength. So we'll notice that we have, you can see that right there's our line in the sand. It's very obvious, right? Line in the sands are just structure, maybe some context. Right there, you can see very obvious, that should be our line in the sand, roughly 28.14. If we can start getting through 28.14, and more than likely you'd want to jump to that 1 minute or that 5 minute chart, get through, then start finding your lower highs for your entries. This is traditional futures, touch brackets or spreads, and then you have all of this room down into the Tuesday POC value rate high to go ahead and fill that gap, some good profit potential. Once or if we do make it there, I'm actually not going to be looking for buy triggers here. Typically, yes, right? That wouldn't be a bad zone to buy, and I'm not saying that you can't, but I'm not going to do it just because of how overbought we are. I'm not looking for buy triggers until at least we make it down into here. Even then, that structure is not very good. But notice that we are up into that plus 0.5. So if we do start trading down here, this will now be the dynamic negative one. Here will be the dynamic negative 1.5, because you add the move up and then down, right? And so there's my first buy zone, and then down here would be my second. Very, very clear cut. So we've got the gap. There's nothing to do yet. We just got to wait and let this chart. We're not going to predict what this chart's going to do. Instead, we're going to react and ride with the movement. Slash NQ is very similar, so there's just not much more to talk about. Line in the sand, very obvious, 71.80. It's a little bit deeper line in the sand. Get through, hold lower high. There's your target. Down in the first demand, second demand, down into there. And then one thing that I actually do like about slash YM is notice that we're not at 5 month highs yet on slash YM. So I like that. We go up into that plus one. Guess what? We actually have resistant structure up there. So if these indices go to the plus one tomorrow, this will be my go-to, because there's actually structure. And then it's the exact same thing to the downside. I don't think this has that good of a setup for set divergence as the other two, and gap fills the other two do. But I do like that VA low negative one. I do think there's really good structure. And then of course there's the second demand right there. So I do really like this chart. Each chart kind of has some, and that's why you don't trade all three at the same time. You pick the one at that in the moment that has the best edge, best context, best content, best prices on NADEX. You pick that one and you ride with that. And then you stick with that one. You don't trade all three at the same time. So message me if you have any questions. Take pictures of all of your trades and post them in the group and in the chat room so that you can get feedback from me and from others.